students. So next, protozoa reproduction. So in previous class we discussed about the protozoa locomotion, now protozoa reproduction. So here protozoa means first organisms on the earth. So in this class we revise the how the protozoa organisms perform the production of the reproduction. So the reproduction means, so the parent body produces the offspring. The process is called as reproduction. So the parent body produce the offspring, that is called as reproduction. So the reproduction is two types in the organisms, animals. Number one is asexual and two is sexual. Asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. Asexual means an organism produces offspring without involvement gametes. So that is called as asexual. A single parent can produce offspring without the involvement of gametes or called as asexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction means fusion of male and female gametes to produce the offspring. That process is called as sexual reproduction. So now in this class we discuss about the asexual reproduction in the protozoa. So the asexual reproduction resulting, so the resulting is newly formed organisms, individuals are resembled to the parents structurally, genetically, so equal to the resemble to the parents. Now hence, so these daughter individuals are called as clone. Daughter individuals are clone, so which is structurally and genetically resemble to the parents. So these sexual reproduction, asexual reproduction, so performed in the different type of organisms, bacteria, Euglena and Paramecium, Archaea. So these type of bacteria are do organisms are do asexual reproduction. The asexual reproductions are classifying into two types. Number one, binary fission. And another word, multiple fission. Multiple fission. So fission means dividing. So here binary fission and multiple fission. So binary fission means the single parent body divides into two organisms or two individuals are called as binary fission. Fission means dividing. Here binary means two. Single parent divides into two individual, so called is binary fission. Multiple fission means the single parent can divides into multiple individuals or called is multiple fission. Here single parent produce many, here single parent produce two, hence it is called binary, hence it is called multiple. So now we discuss about the binary fission. So binary fission means single parent divides into two daughter individuals are called as binary fission. So in this process, first, so the nucleus are divides, so the nucleus are dividing to produce two daughter nucleus, and this karyokinesis is followed by the cytoplasm. So this binary fission is occur in the favorable condition. Favorable conditions means sufficient light, water, food. So when favorable conditions are occur, the binary fission are started in the few organisms. So the binary fissions also divides into two types, classified into two types depending on fission of axis. So for example, this is single parent, So some organisms divides into longitudinally, some organism divides into transversally. So yes, here depending on plane of axis, if the viral fissure is classified into two types. Number one, longitudinal biliary fission, longitudinal binary fission, and number two is transversal binary fission. So this is very important for 4 marks question in IPE. So longitudinal binary fission and transversal binary fission. Now we discuss about the longitudinal binary fission, important 4 marks question in the IPE. This longitudinal binary fission seen in flagellates. Flagellate means an organism which is possess the flagella is called as flagellate. So example organism is Euglena and Trypanosoma. Euglena and Trypanosoma. So this like organism assisted performed by the binary longitudinal binary fission. So now before we discuss the process of binary longitudinal binary fission, so first we see the structure of euglena. So this is about the structure of euglena. So the euglena structure, so it is possess the two flagellas, one is long flagella and another one is short flagella. Anteriorly means top of the body. So the top of the euglena possess the a long flagella and a short flagella. So these flagellas are arise from the basal granule. Basal granule means root of flagella. So next, a cytostome present and also cytopharynx are present and a paraflagellar body and a stigma. So which contractile granule which is present anterior part of euglena. The euglena anterior part having the a pair flagella, cytostome, cytopharynx, paraflagellar body, contractile vacuole and a stigma which is present anterior part. Next, center of the body a nucleus is present. Around the nucleus chromatophores are present. Next, externally covered by pellicle. So the nucleus externally present, so this is the individual externally possesses the pellicle layer. So this is the structure of euglena. Now process, longitudinal process. First, when the favorable conditions are occur, the euglena starts the longitudinal binary fission. Here longitudinal binary fission means the parent body divides into the two halves by longitudinally called longitudinal binary fission. The parent body divides into two individuals. So the axis is longitudinal axis, hence it is called longitudinal binary fission. Once again, longitudinal binary fission definition is the parent body divides into longitudinally to produce the two daughter individuals are called as longitudinal binary fission. So first in the process, the nucleus is divides into two daughter nucleus. This is the nucleus divides by mitotic division to produce the two daughter nucleus. Mitotic division, so this is about the result is produced two daughter individuals. Next, a longitudinal furrow appear middle of the anterior end. So this is the longitudinal furrow which is present middle of the anterior end. So when karyokinesis are completed, karyokinesis mean nuclear division. Nuclear division completed, instantly longitudinal furrow is occur where at the middle of anterior end. So this furrow is gradually extending towards the posterior side. So this process is happened until two daughter individuals are separate. So this is about the longitudinal binary fission. So next, when complete the nuclear division, the chromatophores, basal granules also divides, and after longitudinal furrow is occur. Where during the longitudinal binary fission, the stigma, paraflagellar body and contractile vacuoles are disappear. So which is formed fresh in the two daughter individuals. So the mother flagella retains only one daughter individual, other individual are produced fresh flagella from the basal granule. So this is about the process of longitudinal binary fission. The longitudinal binary fission also called is symmetrogenic division means the result of longitudinal binary fission. So the two daughter individuals are resemble to each other like a mirror image. There is no structurally genetically variations, so equal to each other, hence it is called symmetro means similar. This is about the process of longitudinal binary fission. Yes, this is the longitudinal binary fission.